I think my vagina is gonna look different.
Oh my gosh.
So we're going for the consultation that I fought so hard to get with Mia Aesthetics. I don't know if you guys watched the last video, but okay, we are here and we are about to go in. I don't know if they're gonna let you come in, baby, but we shall see, right? I feel like my vagina is hanging out.
There's a fucking hole in your skirt in the front and the fucking back.
Update. Julio was not allowed to go into the actual appointment with me, and that really struck a nerve with Julio because he's like, I'm gonna be the one taking care of you. I wanna be there when the doctor is answering these questions for you. So I felt bad because he wasn't able to be involved in that. And I also dropped the ball and didn't FaceTime him. I should have FaceTimed him, but everything just happened so quickly once I was in there. So to update you guys, I was actually able to see Dr. Sarza, and he is very nice, very professional, answered all of my questions. The team, the Mia Aesthetics Houston staff clinic team, they were all really nice. And I feel like any worries or hesitations in thinking I'm just another body count to them, like it's a factory, based on the communications that I had with like the booking side of things, those feelings and worries were laid to rest because everyone at the Houston location was just so nice, and any question that I had, they took it seriously. I never felt like I was being rushed while I was there. If anything, I felt like they were really taking their time with me, so that made me feel really good. But I will still hold true to what I said in a previous video. If you guys are going to be booking with Mia Aesthetics and seeing the doctor in person before your actual surgery, as in like before the day before your surgery, if that's important to you, then make sure that you get it in the contract that you're signing that you're going to get that appointment. I don't know, I feel like Mia Aesthetics needs to fix like the booking side of things and the scheduling side of things. So I was able to see the doctor, that was really nice. I made sure that he knew my concerns about having a coin slot belly button, and he was like, well, it just depends on what your current belly button looks like. And I was like, I don't really even know what my belly button looks like. It's been so long since I've actually seen it. So let me show you guys my belly button. So when I hold it up, she's definitely like, I try and make it flat. She's not a coin slot. So I think we will be okay there. And then as far as my incision, I told him, you know, like I want my incision to be nice and low. And then I asked him, because this is the first time that he's like seen me in person. So I asked him, I was like, so what are you thinking my incision is going to look like? And he said that it's really nice that I don't have like fat up here, like intravenous fat. I might be saying that wrong, but fat that's like inside of your muscles. So if you look at me, like you have to relax your stomach. I don't have, like, this is skin up here. And he was like, that's really good because all of this is going to be gone and this is going to be pulled down. And then they're going to be doing liposuction on any other fat that's left up here to get me nice and taut, honey. And then I asked him, so about my incision, what are you thinking? And he was like, well, I think your incision is going to be, well, I told him, I want my incision really low. He said, yes, we could do that. It's going to hit right about where my skin hangs over. And then I asked him how, for, because I am getting an extended tummy tuck. So I asked him, how extended do you think that's going to be? And he said, for me, it's going to be right about to my hip bone. So from here to here is going to be my scar. And then I also asked him, some people get their drains placed on the sides here and here. And I asked him what dictates whether your drains are going to be on your sides or down in like your pubic area. He said that it's basically up to me. So I told him that I want my drains down in my pubic area just because if I do get any scarring from where the drains were, they're not where you can see them. It's going to be down by like my hoo-ha. Speaking of hoo-has, I asked him, I was like, what is my vagina going to look like after this? Because without being too inappropriate or TMI, obviously you're here because you want to know about my experience and my tummy tuck. So let's just be straightforward about this. Right now, my like vagina, pubic area, like the skin hangs down. Like I have loose skin down there as well. And as long as I can remember, like it's always been like that. And I realized after watching a video on YouTube, like I think my vagina is gonna look different. My friend Laura, she got a tummy tuck and she was like, I couldn't stop looking at my vagina. Like I just had never seen it like that. So I asked him, I'm like, is my vagina gonna look different? And he's like, yes, it's gonna look different. And I told him, I said, okay, well then I do have a concern because I don't wanna be like snatched to the gods up here, right? And wearing a tight dress and my vagina be like fluffy and sticking out further than my stomach. And he was like, well, that just depends on if you have like fat in that area. He like touched it and he's like, yeah, I would recommend that you get lipo right there. So I'm like, okay, then yeah, I will be needing to get lipo there. Another thing that we talked about is for the muscle separation in my abdominal wall, muscle plectation, where they basically repair the muscles and bring it back together. Because whenever you are overweight, or more so when you have a child, your abdominal walls separate and there's a space between your muscles. So I wanted him to check me just because I have lost 120 pounds to see what that separation was like for me and if I really needed the muscle repair. So he felt me and he said that I am less than a fingertip separated, which is actually really good for the amount of weight that I've lost. And he said that if I plan on having children in the future, that he wouldn't recommend that I get the muscle repair because it will just come undone. So I will be telling him on actual the day before surgery whether I want that muscle repair done and also if I want the lipo. I'm still unsure about the muscle repair. I feel like he's already given me my answer, but I just want to ask again, like, if I get the muscle repair when I do have a baby, wouldn't it like be less likely that it would separate? Like there would be some reinforcement there. So I'm going to ask him that, and that will be my deciding factor. If he recommends not to get it, then I just won't be getting it. And then I did ask him, I said, so if I don't get the muscle repair, can I use the money that would be used for that to do the lipo on my vajayjay? He's like, well, you don't really get any money back for the muscle repair if we don't do it, because it's all included in the tummy tuck. So I know different doctors are different, and I'm not going to complain about it, because this procedure, the tummy tuck with lipo and muscle repair, was $6,000, but I got $500 off because I'm paying in cash/debit card. So if you pay cash or debit card, you get a discount. So fun tip right there. I have jury duty of all things tomorrow morning. Hopefully I do not get selected for jury duty because my surgery is about 2 weeks away. And then on Friday, today's Wednesday, and then on Friday, I have a really exciting thing that I'm doing for myself. It's like a self-love thing. One of my friends is helping me with. I'm excited to share it with you guys. Yeah. All right. So let's go ahead and just skip to that part because this video is going to be all in one. So skip to Friday. I am really having to do a lot of self-love talk with myself this morning. So today is supposed to be a very exciting day, which I am excited. I'm excited. But today I am doing a farewell photo shoot. It's a farewell photo shoot plus, like, in my head the word existing comes to mind, but it's a photo shoot for my last skin. It's the last time that I will be photographing my loose skin, like, not professionally, but like in a formal setting, like making it the star of the shoot. And I'm just in a funk today, and I don't want to be in a funk going into this photo shoot. I'm just going to exist today. I'm going to exist. I'm not going to be trying to suck it in. I'm not going to be trying to cover my loose skin. I'm kind of nervous. Like, you guys will see. You'll see. All right, I'm here. I'm about to go inside. I have calmed down very much so. But I am a little nervous because this is the most bare that I will have ever been in my entire life, minus the day that my father filmed me coming into this world in my birthday suit. This is the most naked that I will have ever been in front of a camera. So yeah, basically in like bra and thong, and at one point just in pasties. So I'm excited, I'm nervous, I'm not going to tear up. Oh my gosh, I hate that I cry so easily. It's a very sentimental moment for me during this photo shoot because, you know, I've done a lot of mindset and self-love work on myself, especially with accepting the loose skin as it's gotten more and more, and just accepting and loving the shit out of my body as much as possible. And I'll be honest with you guys, there's a side of me that feels like removing my loose skin, it doesn't feel right to a certain side of me, because I've worked so hard in loving my body and the loose skin. And so knowing that this is just going to be like a memory that I'm going to have is just so incredibly special. And I'm just really going to embrace the moment, be in the moment, and not try and hide anything, and just love and accept myself. I do love and accept myself for the body that I'm in.
I feel your presence on my skin, 'cause now I look at you differently. Differently.